Hi, I'm Orville. We're going to talk about Haas brushless servo amplifiers. This procedure should only be performed by a Haas factory outlet technician. Damage to you, your machine, and machine components can result if you're not trained in this procedure. In this video, we're going to talk about what they are, how they work, and when there's a problem, how do we fix it? Servo amplifier is a source of power for the axis servo motor on the Haas CNC machines. There are four versions of the Haas servo amplifiers: the 30 amp, the 45 amp, the 60 amp, and the 90 amp. All four of these amplifiers work the same way. There are two different types of servo amplifier: the smart amplifier that is only fed by 325 volts DC bus, and the non-smart amplifier, which is also fed by 325 volts DC bus and requires a plus or minus 12 volts DC from the low volt power supply. Both amplifiers have a red LED fault light and a green LED power on light that shows the status of the amplifier. The smart amplifier has a unique feature. When the machine is powered on, the amplifiers run an internal calibration process that will adjust and compensate for the internal offsets. This process can take anywhere from 10 to 20 seconds. They also have the ability to protect themselves by generating a fault and disable themselves during abnormal conditions. The non-smart amplifiers do not run a calibration test. As soon as the machine is powered on, they are ready to run. When the amplifiers has a problem, both amplifiers will generate these alarms. Let's look at the machine's symptoms, what the alarms would be for a non-smart amplifier and a smart amplifier, and how to resolve the issues. First, an over-temperature condition occurs on the machine, and this is caused by the cooling fan below the amplifiers fail to work. If the fan is not working, and the control maximum temperature for safe operation is above 122 degrees, the machine will generate an alarm 991 for the smart amp and 161 through 164 for the non-smart amps. The red LED will be present as long as the condition is present. So let's check the fan. Put the machine in e-stop and follow all the necessary safety precautions. Check if the fan is spinning freely. If it's not, just replace it. If the fan is spinning freely, check the voltage across the two pins on the power cord. The voltage should be 120 volts AC. If the voltage is correct, replace the fan. It's defective. If the control door has a filter on it, check the filter to make sure it's not clogged. If the fan is working correctly, the voltage is correct, the filter is clean, but the machine is still generating the alarm from time to time, it's a good idea to invest in a cab cool option. This will help regulate the temperature of the control cabinet. Next, an amplifier overcurrent condition is generated if the axis ran into a hard stop, or a large tool crashed into the workpiece, or a ball screw or linear guide locks up. Then the machine will generate an alarm 992 specific for the smart amplifier, as well as a generic axis drive alarm for that particular axis, which is 161 through 164. Now, for the non-smart amplifier, the machine will just generate a 161 through 164 alarm. If you're not able to clear the alarm, or the alarm keeps coming back, power down the machine and follow all the necessary safety precautions. Allow the red LED light on the vector drive to go out completely before disconnecting the cable from the suspected amplifier. Measure the resistance at HV negative to red, white, and black. The reading should be open. Then measure HV positive to red, white, and black. The reading should be open. A short circuit in any of these measurements is an indication of a defective amplifier. In any case, inspect the motor and cable before replacing any amplifiers. Check the access motor cables for damage. Make sure there are no pinch or having broken wires. If the cable is damaged, just replace it. Next, an amplifier overload condition occurs with the same symptom that occurs with the amplifier overcurrent condition, which can be as obvious as the machine crashed. This will generate an alarm 994 amplifier overload for the smart amps, as well as the 161 through 164 drive fault alarms. Now, in most cases, the machine application is the cause for an amplifier overload alarm. Check the speeds, feeds, and the depth of cut in your program. Reduce the feed rate and the depth of cut, and that will reduce the machine load. Test the alarm by running a shadow cut of the program. If the program runs complete without any alarm, examine the cutting tool for damage and replace if necessary. Next, the smart amplifier fails to calibrate when the machine is powered on. The red LED light on the amplifier comes on and stays on and then generate an alarm 986, calibration failure. The non-smart amplifier do not have that feature. Power down the machine and follow all the necessary safety precautions. Allow the red LED light on the vector drive to go out completely. Inspect the command cable at the amplifier and the processor. To test the amplifier, the machine must be under power. Now, be careful. If you're not comfortable working in this area, contact your local Haas factory outlet for support. With the power on, measure the low voltage power supply voltage level at the processor. Plus 5 to ground, the range should be 4.9 to 5.2 volts DC. Plus 12 to ground, the voltage should be plus 11.85 to plus 12.50 volts DC. Negative 12 volts to ground, the voltage should be negative 11.85 to negative 12.50 volts DC. If the voltage is correct, cycle the power. If the fault stays, the amplifier is faulty and must be replaced. If every access amplifier in the machine has a red LED light and the low volt power supply voltage is correct, then the processor is faulty and must be replaced. Now, contact your local Haas factory outlet for support. Finally, we've gone through and covered the difference between the smart amplifiers and the non-smart amplifiers. Now, the smart amplifiers can be installed on machines that do not have the smart amplifiers. If you're replacing more than one non-smart amplifier, then you will need to add an auxiliary load PCB board. This PCB must be installed on one of the new smart amplifier to stabilize the 12 volts for the low volt power supply. To replace the amplifier, power down the machine and wait till the LED light completely goes out on the vector drive. Disconnect all the leads from the affected amplifier and remove the two fasteners from the top and bottom of the amplifier. Install the new one in the reverse order and test it. We've covered a lot of information on amplifiers, and 99% of the time, the problems you're dealing with is caused by other issues and not the amplifiers themselves. For more information on your Haas machine, visit diy.haascnc.com, or to order replacement parts, visit haasparts.com, and thanks for watching.